Today I'm just going to be showing you a couple of ways to increase the performance of your PC or maintain the performance of your PC. This video is intended for Windows 7 users, and also if you've had your PC for 6 months to a year or older. So I'm just going to be showing you a couple ways to maintain the performance. First thing is Windows 7 comes with something called Ready Boost. So if you have an extra flash drive or jump drive, you can actually use that as virtual memory to increase the performance. I have here already a flash drive plugged in. I highly recommend renaming it to Ready Boost. That way you know not to use it for storage. Keep in mind, if you are using it for Ready Boost, it's best to dedicate it and not use it anymore. So what I want you to do is select the flash drive or jump drive that you would like to use for Ready Boost, and just right click it and hit properties, and just give that a second to pop up. Okay, we are in the options. Just select Ready Boost, and it's defaulted not to use this device because obviously most people will use a flash drive or a jump drive for storage, pictures, whatever the case may be. I'm going to select dedicated and go as high as I possibly can. Hit apply. And okay. Now my jump drive or flash drive is set to help the performance of my PC. So that is one way to increase performance. Another way to help your performance is to do what's called disk cleanup. If you have never done disk cleanup before on any of your computers, this is an absolute must. To get into disk cleanup, I'm just going to show you the quickest way. Hit the start key. And in the search, I want you to type disk. Now, as you can see, disk cleanup and disk defragmenter both showed up when I searched disk. Click on disk cleanup and select the drive you want to do. Now, normally you would pick the C drive because that's the most common. And what disk cleanup is going to do is it's going to get rid of all the temporary internet files, all the junk files. Anytime you surf the web or in every website you ever go to, it logs junk and garbage files. Okay, keep in mind it also removes everything in the recycling bin. So if you have anything in the recycling bin that you want, make sure you untick it. Otherwise, just select everything and hit OK. And we'll delete all that junk. If you've never done that before, it may take an hour or more. Okay, and right underneath there was disk defragmenter. That is also an absolute must. To get to it, once again, the quickest way is just to hit the start key, type disk, and then click disk defragmenter. Now, what a disk defrag does is it organizes the files on the drive so it can get to it quicker and the drive can be more efficient and will actually improve the lifespan of your hard drive, because you have to understand a hard drive is spinning very fast and working very hard to find the files in a timely manner that you are requesting. By doing disk defrag, it'll bring it all closer together and will actually find it quicker. So select the drive you want and hit defragment disk. Once again, that's a process that can take a very long time if you've never done it before. Both disk cleanup and disk defrag, I would recommend doing once every 6 months, even once a year, depending on how heavily the machine is used. But it is something that does need to be done. Okay, so I've showed you 3 out of the 10. I've showed you disk cleanup, disk defrag, and the Ready Boost. Next on my list is spyware scans. If you have never scanned your machine for spyware, chances are you do have quite a bit of it. Now, a lot of antiviruses do come equipped with things to get rid of spyware. Me personally, I do prefer Malwarebytes. It is free. They also have a pro version, but the free version is excellent. I am going to put a link at the bottom of the page here if you would like to try it. As long as it's updated and installed, doing perform a quick scan every once in a while is fine. Keep in mind, it may find things. It may find quite a bit. It may not find anything. Obviously, if it doesn't find anything, that's a good thing for you. And, well, that's just good if you don't have any spyware. If you've never done a spyware scan, I can almost guarantee that it will find something. And when it does, if you just hit fix, delete, whatever the case may be, it will get rid of it. I also highly recommend always restarting your machine after a spyware scan. Well, after spyware scan, that brings us to virus scans. You need to have an antivirus on your machine. Most of the time, if you buy a machine from a store, it'll come with a trial version. Keep in mind that trial version is not good forever. It may be good for 6 months, it may be good for a year, but you do need to have an antivirus on your machine. Now, Windows 7 does have Windows Defender, but you do need to get that through Windows Update, and you do need to keep it up to date. A free virus program, AVG, which I will also have a link for, is a free antivirus. I recommend it if you don't want to pay for an antivirus. Also keep in mind, your internet service provider, whether you have Comcast, AT&T, wow, it doesn't matter what you have, most ISPs will have an antivirus available to you. You do need to call them or log in through their website. For instance, Comcast, I believe, has Norton antivirus. It's a free version for you if you are a paid user. So that's one way to get an antivirus as well. As long as you keep it up to date and scan it once every 6 months or once a year, it will help the performance of your PC. Okay, next on our list is registry cleanup. Every time you uninstall a program or uninstall files or whatever the case may be, it will have junk registry files. Now, to clean your registry, there are a lot of free registry cleaners. I personally prefer CC Cleaner. And it's just a matter of installing it, running it, go to registry, and scan for issues. Once again, if you have never done this, it is going to find a lot. And once it's done with the scan, you can hit fix selected issues. I always recommend backing it up just by the default name. It found 56 issues. Fix all selected issues. Okay, my registry has been cleared. Registry problems have been cleared. Now, the nice thing about CC Cleaner is it will also do exactly what disk cleanup does. It does it faster, and it actually does it a little more efficiently, too. It'll also clear your browser history from Firefox and Google Chrome, which I do not believe disk cleanup does. I believe disk cleanup just does it for Internet Explorer. See, even though I did disk cleanup, it still found things. Okay. Next on our list is msconfig. Now, this one's a little tricky for people because they have to pick and choose what programs they want to start at the very beginning of their computer. That's why we're going into msconfig. To get to msconfig, just hit the start. And under search, type msconfig, and then hit enter. Okay, malware bytes finished. And it didn't find anything. I keep my computer pretty clean. Okay, back to msconfig. Click on startup. These are all the programs that start when you first start your computer. Now, looking through a lot of them, I would leave certain ones alone, but obviously certain things you can tell. For instance, I don't need QuickTime to start up when I first start up the computer. I don't need iTunes. I can leave AVG if I want my security to be on automatically. If you just want it on when you're doing scans, you can even take that off. AOL Instant Messenger, wow, yeah, I do not want that starting up when my computer starts. When you're done picking and choosing the files you want to start, you can just hit apply, hit OK. Keep in mind this will not begin until you restart your computer. I always recommend restarting, but for the sake of the video, we're going to exit without restarting. And just so you can see down here, these are the programs that are running when my computer first starts up. Okay, which brings us to our next one, Windows Update. I know a lot of people that leave it for automatic update, and that's great, and that's fine. Some people don't update their Windows or don't give it time to update their Windows. If you have it set to update automatically, sometimes it defaults to update at 3 a.m. in the morning. But unless your computer's on at 3 a.m. in the morning, it's not going to get the update. So what you can do is hit the Start key. And it's actually in the main directory under Windows Update. Also, if you really want, you can search for it as well. But click Windows Update. And unless you have some sort of pirated software or third-party software that you really can't update your Windows, for instance, some things will only work in Internet Explorer 8 or 9, whatever the case may be. You can still pick and choose what you want to update. Otherwise, just install all the updates and give your computer time to actually do all the updates. That way they actually go through. I mean, there's a lot of security updates that fix security holes, updated drivers that will help your overall performance of your PC. So it is quite important that you do the Windows updates periodically. Okay, number 9 on my list is stress on the video card or the GPU. There's a lot of different things you can do in Windows that will help the performance, and it's actually going to help the overall performance of your PC. For one, I have this beautiful background of the Windows logo, but that's actually using up memory. It's actually taking away resources to display this image. So one thing you can do is you can right click on your screen anywhere, as long as it's not on an icon, and hit personalize. And we're actually going to change it to just be, oh, didn't want to do that one. Okay, give me a second here. What we're going to do is we're just going to change it to a solid color. I don't know if you saw what I did there. But desktop background, just click desktop background. And then go to solid colors. And just pick a solid color that you think would look okay. It's using less resources to display a solid color than it is a full high-res picture. Okay, and with that said, we're also going to change how it displays everything. As you can see, I mean, it has all these transparencies, it has shadows. This does take resources and memory to display. So what we're going to do is we're going to right-click computer. So hit start, right-click computer, go to properties. You can also get to this by going to control panel and going to system. It's the same thing. And we're going to go to Advanced System Settings and Performance, Visual Effects, Processor Scheduling, Memory Usage, and Virtual Memory. Hit Settings. These are all the effects that are being used. Now what you can do is adjust for best performance. Now I always check the bottom one because then it will keep the same format of your start bar. Otherwise, if you have that unchecked, it pretty much looks like Windows 98, and we don't want that. Okay, so your desktop display has been optimized for the best performance, and that'll help your overall performance. Last but not least, number 10 on my list is toolbars. If you go in the Internet Explorer or any of your browsers, you may have an obscene amount of toolbars. They just get in the way. A lot of people don't like them. A couple different things. Some of them will have the X where you can just disable them. I always recommend disabling them. But we want to get rid of them all together. So what we're going to do is we're going to actually uninstall them. To uninstall these toolbars, you do need to have all your browsers closed. So if you're working on something in Firefox, Internet Explorer, or Google Chrome, make sure it's closed out. Okay, to do this, we're going to hit start, go to control panel, and we're going to go to programs, or add or remove programs. Uninstall a program. And now the fun part, you actually have to go through all this and find that toolbar. AOL messaging toolbar. That should be it. Select it, right click it, uninstall slash change. Uninstall, get rid of it. You don't need it. Now as you can see, the toolbar is gone. Yep, now you actually have more space to see your website. Keep in mind there are many more ways to improve the performance of your PC. For instance, adding RAM, hardware-based overclocking, which I did in my other video. But keep in mind this is just for basic users that have never maintained their machine. So that's it. Thank you for watching.